talking about torture. From Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia.
And then, the wikipedia.org.
Cock and ball torture, ZBT, is a sexual activity involving torture of the male genitals. This may involve directly painful activities such as wax play, genital spanking, squeezing, ball busting, genital flogging, urethra play, pickle torture, erotic electrostimulation, or even kicking. The recipient of such activities may receive direct physical pleasure via masochism or knowledge that the play is pleasing to a sadistic dominant. Image, electrostimulation applied on a penis. Contents. Section 1, in pornography. Section 2, ball stretcher. Section 3, parachute. Section 4, humbra. Section 5, testicle cuff. Section 1, in pornography. In addiction to its occasional role in BDSM pornography, Tom O'Carey, literally ball kicking, is a separate genre in Japan. One notable actress in Tamakeri is Erika Nogol, who typically uses her martial arts skills to near kick men in the testicles. Section 2, ball stretcher. A ball stretcher is a sex toy that is fastened around a man in order to elongate the scrotum and provide a feeling of weight, pulling the testicles away from the body. While leather stretchers are the most common, other models are made of steel rings that are fastened with screws, causing additional, mildly uncomfortable weight to the wearer. The length of the stretcher may vary from 1 to 4 inches, and the steel models can weigh as much as 5 pounds. Section 3, parachute. A parachute is a small collar, usually made from leather, which fastens around the scrotum, and from which weights can be hung. Conical in shape, with 3 or 4 short chains hanging beneath to which weights can be attached. Used as part of cock and ball torture within a BDSM relationship, the parachute provides a constant drag and squeezing effect on the man's testicles. Moderate weights of 3 to 5 kilograms can be suspended, especially during bondage. Smaller weights can be used when the man is free to move, when the swinging effect of the weight can restrict sudden movements, as well as providing a visual stimulus for the dominant partner. Section 4, humbler. A humbler is a BDSM physical restraint device used to restrict the movement of a submissive male participant in a BDSM scene. The humbler consists of a testicle cuff device that clamps around the base of the scrotum, mounted in the center of a bar that passes behind the thighs at the base of the buttocks. This forces the wearer to keep his legs forward, as any attempts to straighten the legs even slightly pulls directly on the scrotum, causing from considerable discomfort to extreme pain. Section 5, testicle cuff. A testicle cuff is a ring-shaped device around the scrotum between the body and the testicles, such that when closed that does not allow the testicles to pass through it. A common type has two connected cuffs, one for the scrotum and the other for the base of the penis. They're just one of many. Also, a standard padlock may be locked around the scrotum, and without the key the man may not be able to remove it. Some men enjoy the feeling of being owned, and some people enjoy the feeling of owning their partners. Making the man with testicle cuffs gives a sense that his sexual organs belong to his partner. Equally, there's a certain level of humiliation inherent in the devices, by which some people are sexually aroused. Finally, the cuffs may form part of a sexual fetish of the wearer or his partner.